Hi, this is Andrei Osachuk. I welcome you to the next video training on Analysis Workspace in Adobe Analytics. Today I'm going to show you how to change the width of the columns. And you may wonder what can be easier, but wait for it. I'm going to show you something that you may not know. When you do the analysis, you add more and more columns and more breakdowns, and I build this freeform table on purpose with many different columns. And now I want to read the dimensions. As you can see, all the values are cut off. And obviously this doesn't allow me to properly read my analysis. It's very often when new users start resizing the columns one by one. So for example, they hover the mouse cursor in between a few columns, like in this case, average page views per visit and bounce rate, and start resizing. As you can see, it's very flexible. I can change the width the way I want, and I will try to continue the same approach. And at the end of the day, you can see that the columns are resized the way that the column width is not proportional among different columns. Finally, if I want to make the first column with the dimensions wider, I can do this, but at this point the column's width starts changing proportionally, and anyway the table doesn't look great. And the question is it possible to resize the table so that all the columns will be resized proportionally from the very beginning? Basically, I want to have the column width the same among all the columns. How can I reset the width? You can hover the mouse cursor in between any of the columns and double click. Immediately, all columns will be resized and their width will be the same. Now, if you hover your mouse cursor in between the dimension area and the first metric, and then we'll start move it to the right, you can see that all the columns again are resized proportionally. But the problem is that when you do this, then at some point you can't move it longer to the right. So you see that I can resize it from here to here, but then nothing is being changed. And this is probably something that you faced. However, how you can overcome this? Try to change it in a few iterations. So again, click in between the dimension area and the first metric and start moving to the right again. As you see, again, I was able to move it to the right, but then again got stuck. And if I do another iteration, it will keep working. So in a few iterations, I can resize the table even better. So now all the columns have the same width, and I was able to open the first dimension column. Even if there is a very long value, I will be able to easily read that. This was a short tip of how you can resize the columns and reset the width. Again, to reset, just double click in between two columns, and if you want to resize the columns proportionally, just pull the first column to the right in a few iterations, and this will help you to resize the table. Hope this was helpful. Let me know your thoughts and talk to you soon. Bye.
Hi, my name is Andrei Osachuk. I am an Adobe Analytics consultant. I have worked with Adobe Analytics, formerly Omniture Site Catalyst, for more than 9 years, and implemented it for about 100 of B2C and B2B projects since 2008. Last year, I founded online courses to help my students learn and practice in Adobe Analytics. We work together on solution architecture based on business requirements, implement Adobe DTM and Launch, configure analytics report suites, set up reporting and do data analysis while looking for insights. As you are watching this video, you are likely familiar with my YouTube channel where I share my experience and best practices. Today I'm happy to announce my new video course for analytics developers, architects and administrators that is called Report Suite Configuration in Adobe Analytics. This course will be helpful for everyone who wants to become a professional in Adobe Analytics. And it's also recommended for those who want to plan to get certified on Analytics Architect and Analytics Developer. Even if you haven't had any experience with setting up a report suite, I guarantee you will be able to create and configure a new report suite within 2 days. The course consists of 31 videos and covers all settings of the Report Suite Manager. In each video, I explain the purpose of the setting, give you examples, and share my best practices for configuration. It will take you about a day to watch all videos and another day to set up a report suite following the guidance. I know that questions appear while doing. You may have an experience that after attending a webinar or a training course, you had many questions. Perhaps you had a very specific situation that wasn't covered on that webinar, and then you felt you didn't reach the desired goal as the course didn't help you accomplish what you wanted. This is why I support my students with their questions while and after the training. Everyone who will sign up for this course will be able to contact me directly. So if you have a question on Report Suite configuration after watching this video course, you can contact me and I will help you. Additionally, I give 30 minutes to every student for personal consultation on Adobe Experience Cloud for free. We can discuss your questions on Analytics, Target, Audience Manager, DTM and Launch, and other solutions I'm specializing on as a multi-solution architect. Sign up for this course to become a professional in Adobe Analytics. Talk to you soon.